I think most boxing supporters and followers in the country have been looking forward to ever since it was first announced. I know as a, you know, as a journalist and a commentator, it's one which I think has got all the makings of being an absolutely outstanding night's entertainment. I'm looking forward to it immensely. Tickets are going very well, I'm told. They are still available. So we're hoping that Elland Road is going to be absolutely rammed for what could turn out to be one of the fights of the year. Promoter, of course, is Frank Warren. Frank.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us here today. We're going to have a special night on Saturday. I'm really looking forward to it. We've got 22,000 people at the moment here, and we're obviously, with this great weather we're having, and obviously the sun's shining down on us. I think we're going to be, you know, full to the capacity we set the arena out for, so it should be 25,000 people here. The majority of them will be behind this man. He's in his hometown. Josh has trained, as I know, like a demon for this. He's full of confidence. He's jumping out of his skin. I've never seen him look so fit and well. His dad's done a great job with him. And I think, as I say, we're going to be in for a special contest, a special night. You've got Lee Selby coming into Josh's backyard. That tells you all about him. But, you know, this is going to be, I think, a real hostile environment for him. I know you're all behind Josh. We're all looking to see him come through this, as I am. I'm in Josh's corner. And I think we're going to make a little bit of history. And hopefully this is going to be one of many fights that we'll begin going to be doing here in Leeds and at this soccer stadium over the next few years.
This is going to be a tremendous night's entertainment. Kaiser Chiefs are going to be playing here on Saturday night as well, and I'm happy to be able to report that the weather forecast, long-range weather forecast for Saturday, is very good indeed. They're talking about it being north side of 20 degrees, and it's going to be open, doors open, I think I'm right in saying, at 2 o'clock. Big screens are going to be showing the FA Cup final, and there's going to be boxing from 4 a.m, Frank.
Yep. Yeah, so we've got a great card, and a great undercard, some great fights on there, and as I say, it's going to be good value for money.
Well, let me introduce the people who are here. First of all, to my right is Chris Senegal, who's promoter and manager of Lee Selby. Tony Borg, who trains the champion, the IBF champion. On my left is Sean O'Hagan, who trains Josh Warrington, and the two fighters, of course, Josh challenging for the IBF title and looking sharp as ever, and Lee, who is an outstanding champion. I think everybody knows that about boxing. He might be facing a hostile atmosphere, but I think every boxing fan realises what a very good fighter he is and what a big task it is for Josh to come out as the winner. Well, let's hear from, I think, probably the trainers and managers, first of all. Let's hear from Chris. Tell us a bit about Lee and what you are expecting come Saturday night.
Yeah, we're expecting a tough fight. Lee Selby is in great shape. He's been away sparring in Los Angeles. We've sparred with former world champions, top prospects. He's had the greatest preparation that he can. So there'll be no excuses if anything that does go wrong on Saturday night. He's in great shape, and we've prepared for a very tough fight.
Preparations, Tony, you've obviously been at the centre of that, and you talk about the people he's been in with and where he's been working. Which gym have you been using, first of all? In Los Angeles, where have you been?
In Los Angeles, we were using the Maywood Boxing Gym. That's a Mexican gym where 90% just talk Mexican, Spanish, rather. Then we go into the wild card, really just there for just publicity more than anything else. But all the hard work was done at the Maywood Boxing Gym.
Sean, you were saying before we came up onto the stage that, I mean, I know trainers always say we've had the best ever camp, but you were saying to me, believe it, it really is.
Absolutely. I mean, every trainer, as you say, will tell you that we've had the best camp ever. What I'll say is that you prepare for fighting in front of you. So they've been looking at us fighting like Dennis Seale and previous fights we went before. We prepare for them. specifically, as we prepare for Lee specifically. And this camp has been so relaxed, it's just flawed, absolutely flawed. There's been no flaws, there's been no niggles, everything's gone so smooth, very, very relaxed.
How much sparring have you done in the run-up to this? What sort of preparation?
We've done a little bit extra, to be honest with you, because Lee's got a style that requires it, you know. Let's not forget, he's a very, very good fighter. I'm not going to sit here and say I'm going to fight. Fight's already built. He's a good fighter, and I've always said that. So we'll do a little bit more for this one. Probably a region of about 150 now, 160.
What makes you confident? What do you see that makes you convinced that your man's going to take this title?
Just really, like, I mean, just saying what I've, repeating what I've said, really. I mean, just our preparation was about. We've had some really, really good sparring. We've covered every aspect of the training. We've done more this time. We've thought about it more. We've gone deeper into things. And it's just, it seems so sorted. You know, we've had nothing whatsoever. We've not had any kind of flaws in training. I could count on one hand in all those rounds that we've sparred. I could probably count on one hand the amount of time has been. And that's not me just saying that for everybody here, to make it fair, that's genuine.
Tony, you've been looking after this fellow. How's his preparations been going?
First class, it's always first class. He always puts everything into his training sessions. He doesn't mess around outside of the gym. His life is all boxing. Preparation's gone perfectly as it always does. I think a lot's been put on, everyone's going on about how he's going to deal with this hostile crowd. Going to thrive on it,
please. What makes you so confident of that? Because there's a few people here today who will be part of that hostile crowd. What makes you so confident?
I'm not confident, I'm 101% certain. If you sell, you'll go out there and thrive on the hostilities.
What about Josh as a fighter?
Yeah, he's a good fighter, very good fighter all round. But he's an elite fighter, he's a little further, I believe.
So, what's going to be the key in the styles between the two? In your opinion?
I'm not going to tell you that you'll fight.
Okay, let's hear from the two guys who were feisty in the pre-fight interviews, and I'm sure it's going to be more of the same today. Josh, let's start with you. How are you feeling?
I'm relaxed. Yeah, we had a bit of fun at the last press conference, didn't we? And the interviews and everything else we went about, but for me, I feel like I don't really need to say no more. You know, the last few months I've really put my body through well, give it absolutely everything. Every time I've gone into the gym, I give 100%. Just worked hard, constantly thinking about this is what it's all been leading up to. After all them years, after all the talk of, you know, me and Lee potentially fighting, it come down to this camp and like I say, every session I've gone in, I absolutely give it everything. So, you know, the fans have turned out in the numbers. Can't thank them enough. Supporting on this journey, it's been a hell of a journey, and it's for them as well as me. And now I just want to get in the ring and do the business. You know, Saturday is going to be a magnificent event. It's going to be a hell of a day. We're blessed with nice weather. You know, we've got the Chief returning home, and the Kaiser Chiefs playing us out just to add to that a little bit more special atmosphere. And yeah, I'm ready to lift that world title above my head.
Yeah, come on, John.
Non-Leeds United fan who's watching this live, maybe on the net or wherever. The Chief being Lucas Radebe.
The Chief being Lucas Radebe. And like I say, I feel like this is, you know, meant to be. I talk a lot about destiny. You know, many years ago, well, a few years ago, you know, there was a chance for fighting for a world title, and it didn't come off, and I would never be meant to get me an opportunity again. But you know, certainly how things have gone. Anything could have happened in them couple of years. Lee could have moved up weight, could have been beat. You know, things could have happened to me, but it's come round and it's just come out. I'd always dreamed about it. I've always planned it. I've always said that I'd like to fight for world title at Elland Road. It's here. It could have happened. It could have been in the arena, but it's here, Elland Road. You know, I've always said that if I had a ring walk, because I always said I've a former Leeds player down there, whether it's Brian Owens or United, I'd have the Chief. He's turned up. The Kaiser Chiefs have agreed to play us out. It's all falling into place. All I've got to do now is get in the ring, do the business on Saturday and wait till it's first world champion.
Yes!
Just how much it would mean as a Leeds boy, as a Leeds United fan, to have that IBF Champions belt around your waist when the fight's finished on Saturday night. Can you imagine that?
I've dreamt it many times, like I say, so I'm just ready to go now, you know. I don't feel like there's no need for any bad talking. On Saturday, I get to punch my face in, so, you know, there's no more need for sparring. And yeah, mate, just beyond dreams, especially because I've been written off, like, more or less since winning the British title. No one would expect me to win a European, then go on. And every fight from there, it's like, Warrington's going to get found out here, but I've just carried on going, and the fans have stuck behind me. And, you know, one thing I can say, I'm very proud of that. You know, they're very, very loyal. And like I say, we're doing this together. It was just great to be history for the city, and no matter what happens after Saturday night, you know, I'll always be there in history books as Leeds' first world champion, so something to be very, very proud of.
Lee, coming here as the world champion, and I think by any recognition, you know, it's kind of walking into the lion's den, isn't it?
Well, you could say that, but, you know, the title world champion, I should be willing and ready to defend my title anywhere in the world. You know, it's only 4 hours up the road, 5 hours up the road from where I live, so it's not so much of a lion's den to me.
And how are you feeling? What are your thoughts about stepping into that arena when, I mean, you will have your supporters, but I think it's fair to say there'll be more for Josh.
I think the supporters are better, but it's just another defence, and it's just another fight.
And are you going into it with the mindset, as Tony said, that he's a good fighter, but not an elite fighter?
To be honest, I treat every opponent the same. I prepare myself. I don't like train for a certain style or certain opponent. I train to get myself right. Whatever happens on the night, I know I've done my. I've done the best I can to make sure I'm ready. Whatever happens on the night happens on the night.
How's your weight? Because you're a big lad for the featherweight limit. Are you going to be there and okay at the weight?
Of course. I've been making the 9 stone limit since maybe 2008. I've done every time. I've never come in on the weight. I'm always underweight. I think I was 2 pounds light in the last fight. Weight's a little.
Forget me. Tell Josh what you think's going to happen on Saturday night.
Just like the previous defences, and a woman believes all of it.
Not just ours.
Josh?
Huh? What'd you say?
Get beat on this time,
lad. Don't be silly. Swap
names now, lad. It should be Josh there, not
Chris Elgin. Go on, Josh. What do you reckon? Anything you'd like to say to him?
Not really. Like I say, you know, I'm glad that he's prepared the way he has done. Because, like I say, you know, he's knocked me many, many times over years. And on Saturday night, I've got my chance to show him, to prove to him, and not proving to him. It's all about that. It's about the world title, and it's about, you know, doing it for the city and everything else. But exactly. And it's just a little bit nicer than him. Obviously, you know, like it's him who gets to punch in face after discrediting the fans and everything else over the years, and you know, discrediting me. So listen, you know, carry on with your pictures this week, Lee, with that belt and everything else, because it's staying here, pal. Once it comes here, that world title's staying here.
Yeah. I'm not going to instigate an argument, it's not what you're looking for, no chance. I'm a humble guy. You know, you seen that in the first press conference, he was running his mouth like that. The guys in Leeds wanted to win, but the whole country are back in here and hoping I win. I'm sure, like, you see it every time at Box Nation or tweets or do something on Instagram, you get an alert on your phone, you see all the abuse you get.
You've got
Hazel
Brown on your side,
Lee.
Hazel
Brown! He was a great fighter.
He was a great fighter.
Listen, can I keep up fans in country, you know, from wherever, from top Scotland to bottom London. I'd rather have all these behind me any day.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. 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 Always supporting me in there, and they always send out the numbers. So listen, there'd be 20,000 there, and I'm proud to have the numbers behind me.
25.
You know, 25, whatever. And you know, it's funny all them boys who don't want me to win outside of Leeds. Listen, no one likes Leeds.
It's all country.
We love it. No, we love it. All in Leeds. But,
look how much more than this. A few more than this.
If you can get to the Los Angeles gym wheeling.
Was there any of this?
We don't need any of them. This is boxing, not football. There's two men in the ring.
Does the crowd and the hostile atmosphere which you are going to get, does that worry you at all?
What are them bumblies going? Was hostile?
Hostile.
Don't be stupid.
Let's get some proper questions from the floor, from the press and people who've come here today. Anything for the guys who are up here? Nick? Shout them up.
Wait's colour at belt getting changed. No
one was there an English, what did you say?
How punch I did myself. So when's colour at belt getting changed? No one likes red.
Next.
Any more?
Yeah, come on, Lee. Tell us what's going to happen.
Let's have some questions from the press, please. Dev?
I don't even know if he knows himself, to be honest with you. You know, he takes a humble approach. You know, credits me as a fighter, and then he goes to another interview and discredits me. I don't know what his thoughts are. He'll know after Saturday night, because he'll have to. He'll be, you know, over the years saying I won't get to his level and I'm just an average fighter and blah, 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 and all that stuff. But that'd be embarrassing for him to be losing his title to just an average fighter, boy. So, you know, I don't care, to be honest with you, if he respects me or not. At the end of the day, it's about that belt and winning that belt for Sid and for myself. And you know, it's just a nice added incentive that, like I say, I get to punch him in the face.
Lee,
yes.
Compared to your previous four challengers, where does Josh compare with them? If you was doing a list of 1, 2, 3, 4.
Well, if I was giving a list of the names of the fighters, you wouldn't pick one of the top. The last guy you'd pick is like the easiest defence, and then you'd have to pick Josh just to the other guy's resumes. What one than that, anything could happen.
Out of all the people that you have fought, do you think that you've ever fought anybody that's got that say, back power of the fans behind. I know you say it's too many. There are
probably not the same backing of the fans, but you know, they're all professional fighters challenging for a world title.
They do, definitely, I agree with that.
They all got the hunger and the desire. Otherwise, they shouldn't be there, you know.
Do you not think in your mind for 1 minute that the desire of this kid and the 25,000 leagues behind you is just going to end up destroying them?
Why destroy them? I never get overwhelmed. It's a fight. I'd expect that for less than people there. If we was going to have a fight outside, I'd expect like a crowd to be around me shouting and screaming. That's what a fight is.
Lee, there's a bit of a feeling within the sport, I think, and among the supposed experts, that this guy's style is probably not what you would choose, because he's going to be in your face and he's going to fight 3 minutes of every round, and there's going to be no chance to switch off and take a little walk and buy a few seconds, because he's going to be on you.
So, some experts say that, but other experts say his style is staying away from him. You know, keep coming pressure, me boxing on the back foot, picking him off as he comes in. But that's the great thing about boxing, it's opinionated. It's an opinionated sport.
Do you think your style's right to give him a nightmare night?
All I'll say, John, is I'm able to adapt when I've had the styles of like what people come forward to me, or because I'm known as a forward pressure fighter, I've always been able to adapt and do what I need to do to win, and I think that's what will separate these fighters, how bad I'm willing to go and how far I'm willing to go. And like I said, Lee will want to keep hold of his belt, but I just want this so bad. I want this so bad, and for the years and the years and going through, you know, all the hard graft training sessions and the fights previous and the pressure of having the fights beforehand, just to this moment, and I'm just ready for this weekend, you know, and I'll just give absolutely everything, every ounce of energy in my body to win that world title.
How do you think it's going to end, Lee? Do you think you'll stop it? Do you think it's going to go the distance? What do you predict?
Just Lee said we're winning. You know, I'm no Muhammad Ali, I can't predict the round or anything like that, but I just see myself winning. And if I didn't, I shouldn't be here.
And you can match that determination, can you, having been, you know, you're the champion and you're trying to get up to that level again?
If you're a professional boxer and you haven't got that desire, that determination to become a world champion, you shouldn't be in the game.
Any more from the floor? Any questions for any of the guys? Dev?
Yes, like Carl Franklin's going to be ringside. Is that going to be a distraction? Have you got one eye on him? But after this fight, questions to both of you.
For me, taking the fight as it comes. Obviously, it's nice to have an idea of where you want to go for it in your career. Potentially down the road, yeah. A big fight with Carl. I only seen him last week, and I said the same thing to him. I said, when I get through this one on Saturday, you know, I'd like to potentially get a fight with you in the future. But I mean, all my focus and attention is on Saturday. No, no matter who will be there, if you get all the world champions in, what is trying to me, it's my mind's on myself, only myself, only.
Having Carl Frampton there won't be a distraction at all. But if I come through Saturday night, okay, that'd be the fight I'd want to go straight into next. You know, you got a date in August, I think. I'd go straight into it.
You'd be happy going to Belfast then?
Yeah, of course, yeah. I boxed there before, and it was a great experience. Packed out arena again, and I read it, so it was.
And if you won, would you be happy to go to Belfast?
When I win, yeah, I'd like to take the boys and the girls on a little away day. We had a good time when we went to Berlin a few years ago, and I think 10,000 of those fans in Belfast would be a good day out.
What's the score with that one, Frank? What's there to be made, you know, for a winner to get that fight? It's a fight that everybody wants to see, be a unification fight. Where it takes place, we don't know yet. But let's get this one out of the way first of all. You know, there's a great series of fights to be made. You don't know how this fight's going to be. This may be a very close fight. Maybe a return, it may be a trilogy. Who knows how it's going to be? It's just, it's, all you know, it's got fight written all over it. See something special on the night. Yeah, I mean, you've been promoted a lot of big fights. I mean, how highly do you rate this one compared with some of the great fights you've been involved in the past?
It's up there with all of them. I mean, you know, first of all, a fight
fight is what it's all about, and we've got a great fight. The second thing is the atmosphere. Well, look at these guys, this is the press conference. Imagine what it's going to be like on the night. It's going to be a fantastic atmosphere, it's going to be lively, we're going to have some good fights on the undercard. It's just going to be a fantastic event, and the cherry on the cake is hopefully, I'm very confident that Josh can bring up the prize to Leeds. Josh, final message to this guy?
Final message, I'll finish on saying it's interesting to say that you listen to your prediction, Lee. Obviously, you're just going for a win, but it's interesting to say that you're not going to bang me out in this Hanover and say the final bell. Obviously, you'll be confident going into the ring, but there's no way that you can or would be able to prepare for what you're going to expect on Saturday night. With myself and the crowd, it always gets said about the crowd are not in there with me, but I certainly feed off that energy. And walking into a crowd like this, it's a little bit different. We just do things different than Leeds. I'll finish on saying to the fans, in your numbers, thank you for over the years. So, and I've fed off your energy over the years. If you've been to one fight, if you've been to all of them, which many of have, since the small shows in the leisure centres when I was last on to these big events. Now, Ellen Road, thank you very much, and make the noise in the stands, and I'll deliver everything else in the ring, and let's get that fucking world title. Yeah. Come on. Oh,
come on. Final message as the champion, message to Josh.
I'll keep it short and sweet. I'm looking forward to making a successful fifth defence. Moving on to the next one.
Thank you very much indeed. If you've got anything else to say, now's the time to say it.
Can I just say one thing?
Yep.
Okay. What I would like to point out is that press conference, sorry, not press conference, public workouts come tomorrow. The way. For all we do appreciate your support, what we do want, we want to show Lee a little bit of respect. He's the world champion, he's coming here, he's given us opportunity. Let's bear that in mind. So, well, a bit of banter's okay, I'd comment here and there. Let's not get too silly, yeah? You can just put that message out to everybody. Let's keep it there, show him a little bit of respect.
Well said.
Yeah. Right, we're going to be doing some photographs for the press photographers first of all here, and then broadcast media, broadcast television, will be doing interviews out on the pitch or in the stand, and then sit-down interviews and one-on-ones with the internet guys and the newspaper journalists who are here following that. So photographs first of all, and thank you very much everybody for your views. It's going to be a special night, and Frank would want me to amplify that tickets are still available for the night. We want to see Ellen Road absolutely rammed for what could be one of the fights of the year. Thank you very much for coming here today.
We want all those people from around the country to come buy some tickets. No relief guys again.
First time that a big open-air show has been on here at Elland Road. It's been a spicy build-up, what is quite definitely going to be one of the fights of the year.
So yeah, Lee, after all the interviews, after all the talking, we're here.
Pop, pinging you with a jab, your head's going back and forth like Noddy.
Put on this persona of being this bad man. You aren't a bad man, you aren't no bad man, you're from Barry.
Okay, what do you got to say?
End of the day, you give the big one about being this nasty, vicious fighter, and then out of ring, you can't even do an interview, you can't even talk properly.
For years you've said you're going to see the best out of me. We're still waiting.
I think you've got yourself emotionally attached to me.
You've said that you're going to knock Josh out.
I'm going for the stoppers.
You said yourself that I missed my opportunity, that I'd never get an opportunity to fight for a world title. It's here, in Leeds.
Destiny is taking its toll. Destiny's unfolding in front of us.
I'm going to make it the hardest night of your life. You're going to be going back to your stool every round thinking, I don't want no more of this.
Well,
all your fans are going to go home with their hands on their heads. And this is folk who I know personally are going to be hanging over, shouting, begging for your blood. They don't like you. The Brad's going back to where he belongs, home in Wales. May 19th, get to find out what Josh Warrington and the Leeds fans are all about. I'm the new. See you on Friday.